Please welcome the co-founder of Google and co-founder of the Breakthrough Prize, Sergey Brin, and Academy Award-winning actress, Gwyneth Paltrow.
We spend a third of our lives asleep, but why? What is the brain doing during that time? Why does it generate dreams? And how does it switch between sleeping and waking?
Sleep is one of nature's great enigmas, and not just to people who slept through science class. Even brilliant neuroscientists. Make some noise, neuroscientists in the house. Okay. They've even struggled to shine a light on the world of the night.
That made it hard to create treatments for disorders like narcolepsy, where the sleep cycle is chronically disturbed. People with narcolepsy can suffer from debilitating tiredness, daytime hallucinations, even sudden collapse.
But through tireless efforts, working both like a dog and with a dog, our next laureate succeeded in figuring out the causes of narcolepsy and found new clues to the mystery of sleep.
For most of us, sleep comes at nightfall. But for some, the line between sleep and waking is not so solid. Emmanuel Mignot is trying to crack the puzzle of narcolepsy, the sudden intrusion of sleep into waking life. And through it, an even bigger mystery: how the brain chooses to shut down and reawaken. For years, he's been on the trail of the mutant gene that causes narcolepsy in animals. But when he finds the gene and the brain receptor it builds, the mystery only deepens. This mutation barely occurs in humans. So how do humans get narcolepsy? Then comes a new lead. In the lab of Masashi Yanagisawa, they find orexin, the molecule that triggers Mignot's brain receptors to control wakefulness. And then, the smoking gun. Mignot discovers that in narcolepsy, the immune system shuts down production of orexin, disrupting the brain's ability to choose between sleep and waking. These discoveries are leading to new treatments for narcolepsy and bringing us a step closer to unraveling the mysteries of sleep.
For discovering that narcolepsy is caused by the loss of brain cells that promote waking, paving the way for the development of new treatments for sleep disorders,
the Breakthrough Prize in Life Sciences goes to Emmanuel Mignot and Masashi Yanagisawa.
I've always been a scientist. I always loved science. When I was a kid, I was blowing up my bathroom with chemical experiments. I was washing fossils, and I plugged all the things in my house. And I think science is really fantastic and a lot of fun. I've been lucky because, thanks to my collaborators, I've been able to find something that made a difference to patients with a sleep disorder, narcolepsy. So, unless the word goes to the dogs, but maybe it wouldn't be that bad after all. I think there's a lot of excitement, and with AI, where people are going to do more and more discoveries, and I think it's a new dawn for science.
You know, I got into this fascinating field of sleep research by accident. I really appreciate that this field of sleep research has been on the back burner of brain science, so to speak, for a long time, has been finally celebrated and recognized in this way. Thank you so much.
Okay, wait, stay here, guys. Yuri persuaded me to do something different this year, and he asked me to do some magic. And this is going to involve pretty much everyone in this room, except for you, Katy Perry. Katy's been my magic nemesis. Every trick I've done for her has bombed, and she has mercilessly joked about it afterward. But there are two important things I want you to know. First of all, for you guys here, and everybody in the audience, everybody think of some idea, some word related to science, but not your specific subject, and including you guys. Try to think of a word. But you're not going to tell anybody about it, okay? It's just in your mind, just that one word. Also, you'll notice that there are decks of cards that are in front of you. I did a little AI magic from Gemini that made them, but don't open them. Do not open them yet. Anyway, thank you very much.